Now I will discuss straight line motion mechanisms. There are two types of straight line motion mechanisms. First one, the exact straight line motion mechanism and approximate straight line motion mechanism. This Bessellier's mechanism is an exact straight line motion mechanism, and Robert mechanism is an approximate straight line motion mechanism. And this straight line motion mechanism is used to guide the cutting tool in a machine to trace exactly a straight line. That cutting tool must move exact straight line. Okay, in that case we are using this Bessellier's mechanism or the exact straight line motion mechanism. It is also used in the cutting torches, okay, to move exactly in a straight line. And this is the Bessellier's mechanism. In this Bessellier's mechanism, here the links OC is equal to OD, and also here this AC is equal to BC is equal to BD is equal to AD in this case, okay, in this mechanism. And this O1 is equal to O1P, because it is a diameter, it is a OP is a diameter, and this O1 is a exactly at the midpoint, and it will trace a path exact straight line. Okay, that we will see in the next slide. Here this is the animation of the Bessellier's mechanism, and it will trace exact straight line. Okay, this is the path which is traced by the Bessellier's mechanism. Okay, next we will see that condition for exact straight line motion mechanism. Here the principle adopted for mathematically correct or exact straight line motion is as shown in this figure. Here O, let O be a point on the circumference. This is the circumference of the circle. O be a point on the circumference of the circle of diameter OP. Here this is the diameter OP. Here let OA be any chord. Okay, this OA is a chord on the circumference, and B is a point on OA produced. Okay, we have to extend this OA, or we have to produce this OA. We will get the point B produced such that OA by OB, this OB is equal to constant. Okay, because if it is constant, then it is a straight line. Okay, that is the thing which we are considering in this exact straight line motion mechanism. That principle is used in the exact straight line motion mechanism. Then the locus of a point B, this is the locus of, will be a straight line. Okay, it will trace a path exact straight line. Straight line perpendicular to the diameter OP. Okay, this B, this is perpendicular to OP. This line, this is the line which is traced by point B, which is perpendicular to OP. That means it is exact straight line. Okay, that we can observe this in this animation. It will trace exactly a straight line. And in the Robert mechanism, this is an approximate straight line motion mechanism. Here in this Robert mechanism, this link, if we consider, we will consider this entire thing is a single link, and it is a four bar mechanism, and here all these links are having the equal length. Okay, if we consider, this is L1, link 1, link 2, link 3, and this here it is, this this is exactly at the midpoint, and this is a ternary link. Okay, this one is the ternary link, and all other links are the binary links, and it will trace a path, an approximate straight line. Okay, it is nearer to the this link AD. If we consider, this is AD, it is nearer to this AB, and to increase the accuracy we need to increase the height. Okay, that to get the accuracy. And here all the links are having the equal length in a Robert mechanism. Bessellier's mechanism in exact straight line motion mechanism, and Robert mechanism is an approximate straight line motion mechanism. Here we can see this, we can observe the animation of this Robert mechanism. See here, this entire link is a single link, and this is one link, and this one is the other, and this is the third link, and we will consider this as a fourth link. Okay, all the links are having the equal length. Next, we will discuss some other mechanisms. In that, pantograph, toggle mechanism, ratchet and pawl mechanism, Geneva wheel mechanism, Ackermann steering gear mechanism. Now we will discuss one by one. First, we will consider pantograph. And this pantograph is a copying mechanism. We will call this pantograph is a copying mechanism. It is used to enlarge or reduce movements. Okay, here, see here, this is a larger circle and this is a smaller circle. It is used to enlarge or reduce the scale of the drawing. Here, this one is a pantograph. It is used to enlarge or reduce the scale of the drawing. Okay, in this pantograph is used to reduce or enlarge the drawings or maps, and it also used for guiding the cutting tools or cutting torches to displace here to duplicate the complicated shapes. Okay, to do if the shape of the component is complicated, to duplicate the complicated shapes we are using this pantograph. And this pantograph is also used in engraving or profiling machines. Okay, this is the application of the pantograph. Then in the next slide we will see how it will copy. This is the proof for copying the mechanism. It will enlarging or reducing the scale of the drawing or the maps. Okay, now I'll consider this diagram. Here in this figure, triangle ODA and triangle OCE are similar. This is ODA and OCE. Triangle ODA and OCE are similar triangles, and as angle COE is common, this angle COE, this is common, this angle COE is common for this one and this triangle. Angle COE is common, and angle ADO is equal to angle ADO is equal to angle ECO. Here, this angle and this angle, angle ADO is equal to angle ECO. As AD is parallel to EC, this AD is parallel to this EC here. This AD is parallel to EC. Hence, OD by OC, this OD by OC is equal to OA by OE. This is OA by OE is equal to AD by EC. This one is AD by EC. Then, as all the links are rigid from the displaced position, here we have similar type of diagram here, because it is a copying mechanism. Only the dimensions will change. Okay, the shape will remain same. Okay, the here CO is equal to C dash O. Here this CO is equal to C dash O. This one C dash O. And DA is equal to D dash A dash A dash. DA is equal to D dash A dash. And OD, this one, this is the OD, is equal to OD dash here, OD dash. Then CE is equal to CE is equal to C dash E dash, C dash E dash. And CD is equal to this CD is equal to C dash D dash here. It is C dash D dash. Then OD dash divided by OC dash. This is OD dash by OC dash. This one OC dash is equal to A dash D dash. This one is A dash D dash by E dash C dash. Okay, here this triangle OD dash A dash, OD dash A dash is approximately equal to triangle OC dash E dash. OC dash E dash. This triangle is equal to this. As angle C dash OE dash, angle C dash OE dash is common for both the triangles. Then we will get O dash OD dash divided by OC dash is equal to A dash D dash by E dash C dash is equal to OA dash by OE dash. Then hence it proves that it is a copying mechanism, or it will enlarge or reduce the scale of the drawing. This is the application of the pantograph mechanism. And next I'll discuss the toggle mechanism. And what is this toggle mechanism and where we are using this mechanism? This toggle mechanism is a slider crank mechanism. Okay, this is, we can observe this. This is a slider crank mechanism. But here there are six links in this mechanism. This is the fixed link 1, crank 2, 3, 4, 5, and this is the slider is the sixth link. There are six links in this toggle mechanism. Here in the toggle mechanism, as the crank approaches one of the dead center position, here this is the crank. Here this one is the crank, link 2 is a crank. As the crank approaches one of its dead center position, the movement of the slider approaches 0. Okay, this is the movement of the slider in this direction. Movement of, as it, this crank link 2, crank is a link 2 here, this approaches one of its dead center position, the movement of this slider approaches 0. Here the ratio of the crank movement to the slider movement approaches infinity. The ratio of the crank movement and the slider movement, okay, the here it is a slider movement, approaches infinity, which is proportional to the mechanical advantage. Okay, this principle is used in toggle mechanism. Here it is used where a large force acting through a short distance is required. Okay, this toggle mechanism is used where we need a large amount of force in a short distance. In such cases we will use this toggle mechanism. Here this length BC, link length BC is equal to this BO4, or the link 5 is equal to, length of the link 5 is equal to the length of the link 4. Here for a given value of P, okay, this is a for given value of P, the links 5 and 4 approaches collinear position. For the given value of P, the here the link approaches the collinear position. Here the these links 4 and 5 are having the equal length, and as the force F, sorry, here as the force F is the given, for a given value of the force F, these two links 4 and 5 approaches collinear position. If these two are on the same position, this angle alpha is equal to 0. The force, and here the P, this value of P rises rapidly. Okay, if they both the links 4 and 5 are on the same line, this force rises rapidly, and that concept is used in this toggle mechanism. And these toggle mechanisms are used in toggle clamps, riveting machines, punch pressers, then stone crushers, and also they are used in switches, circuit breakers, and other mechanisms where a snap action is required. We are using this toggle mechanism, and this is the animation of this toggle mechanism. This one, there is a rapid rising of the force in a short distance, where we are applying the large amount of force in a short distance. In such cases, we are using a toggle mechanism. Next, I'll discuss ratchet and pawl mechanism. What is this ratchet and pawl mechanism? And this ratchet and pawl mechanism and the Geneva wheel mechanism are called as intermittent motion mechanisms. This is the ratchet and pawl mechanism, and this is the Geneva wheel mechanism. These are called intermittent motion mechanism. Here, an intermittent motion mechanism is a linkage which converts continuous motion into intermittent motion. Continuous motion, here the continuous motion into intermittent motion. First, I'll consider ratchet and pawl mechanism. This is the ratchet and pawl mechanism. This mechanism is used to produce intermittent circular motion, an oscillating or reciprocating member. Okay, here this one, the oscillating or the reciprocating member, this one, this is the oscillating. This is, here it is a oscillating member. And this ratchet consists of a ratchet wheel and pawl. This is called the ratchet, and this one is called the pawl, as shown in this figure. As the pawl lever is raised, okay, here, instead of that, this is a spring mechanism is used to raise this pawl. Okay, that pawl drives the wheel counterclockwise. Okay, this pawl drives the wheel counterclockwise like this. This is a pawl and this is a ratchet. Counterclockwise, as the pawl lever is lowered, the pawl slides over the ratchet teeth. Okay, these are the number of teeth on the ratchet wheel. As the pawl lever is lowered, the pawl slides over the ratchet teeth. Then ratchets are used in feed mechanisms. Okay, this is the application of ratchet mechanism. These are used in feed mechanism and lifting jogs, clocks, watches, and counting devices. Okay, that count in counting machines or the counting devices, this ratchet and pawl mechanism is used. Okay, this is the animation of this ratchet and pawl mechanism. Okay, this is moving in the counterclockwise direction, and it will not come back. This ratchet, the movement of the ratchet is only in the one direction. Next, Geneva wheel mechanism. This is the Geneva wheel mechanism. In this mechanism, here there is a plate. Okay, this here this one is a plate. Here, this one plate is the driver, and this is the driver. Okay, here this one is a driver, and there is a pin here. Okay, there is a pin which engages just the slot in the driven link. This is the driven link, and this is the driver link. And this is a pin which engages in the slot in of the driven link. The slots are positioned so that the pin enters and leaves them tangentially. And here the advantage of this mechanism is that it provides indexing without impact loading. Okay, here in this case, this is the driven and this is the driver, and it is a pin here on the driver mechanism, and it is engaging with the slot in the driven mechanism. The driven member rotates. In this case, the driven member rotates 1/4 of the revolution for every revolution of the driver. Here, for 1/4 of the revolution, the driven member rotates 1/4 of the revolution for every revolution of the driver. This is the driver and this is the driven. And there is a locking plate here. in this driver, the lock which is mounted on the driver, the locking plate which is mounted on the driver prevents the driven member from rotating except during the indexing period. Okay, that locking plate will helps from rotating. Okay, that driven member from rotating except during the indexing period. And this mechanism is used in clocks and watches, and also it is used in strip of film in a quick advance in the early motion picture projectors. Okay, this Geneva wheel mechanism is earlier it was using in a picture motion picture projectors. Okay, these are the some of the intermittent motion mechanism, ratchet and pawl mechanisms, and Geneva wheel mechanisms are the intermittent motion mechanisms.